Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the St. Mark's Kids Chat. Today we have a very special Kids Chat that's dedicated to Pastor Beyer and to Mary Beyer, because today is the day that we're celebrating Pastor's retirement, and we're just so thankful for both Pastor and Mary's service to St. Mark. So our Kids Chat today is all about how God's words inspired Pastor Beyer and Mary Beyer to bring blessing to St. Mark. So come on down. We have a little bit of a demonstration that we're going to do. So come on down here. All right. So as you can see, we have a little cup right here. And I'm going to pour out this other little pile of cotton balls. Here, sit up for just 1 second, Maxie. So I have this giant pile of cotton balls. Does this look bigger than the cup?
Yes.
What do you think, right?
It's definitely bigger than the cup.
There's a couple more in there. Okay. So this is a giant pile. And let me ask you something. Do you think we can fit all of these inside of the cup?
Definitely.
I don't know. We'll see. So what's going to happen is this cup is going to represent St. Mark, okay? And then this pile of cotton balls are going to represent the blessings that Pastor Beyer and Mary Beyer have brought to St. Mark.
Oh, blessings.
So let me ask you something. If I fill up this water, or if I fill up this cup with a little bit of water, do you think it's going to be harder for me to fill up this entire cup with all of these blessings?
Yeah, because it takes up space.
Maybe, yeah, maybe. So, but you know what? God is so amazing. God is so amazing because, you know what? He has given Pastor Beyer and Mary Beyer just so many amazing things to bless our church with. And I bet that I can fit all of these into St. Mark, or into the St. Mark cup, okay? So let's do that really quick. Let's start with a couple of things. So Pastor Beyer is so creative, right? Is he a creative guy? Mm-hmm. He sure is. He's always forward thinking. He's always trying to think of ways that we can continually try and better the church and reach more people with the word of God. And the same for Mary too. She is amazing at planning events and doing all of these amazing things. She was always there helping out and doing such great things. So there is a Bible verse that says, Psalm 139, I will give thanks to you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. Now let me ask you something. Is God creative?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And that Bible verse says, that says, wonderful are your works. Are we God's work?
Mm-hmm.
Right? He created us. And did he create Pastor Beyer and Mary?
Mm-hmm.
He sure did. Exactly. Yes, he created us to be creative, right? So that is an amazing blessing to our church. Amazing. So some other things too. You know, sometimes pastors are people who we call when things are going hard, you know, like if things are really difficult and, you know, we're having a hard time. Do we call our pastor if we're having a hard time? Careful, Max. So yes, we do. So we call our pastor if somebody's in the hospital. Do we usually send pastor an email? Yeah, we sure do. And so, or if somebody has passed away, if they're sick or anything like that. So it says in the Bible, James 1:12, it says, blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. So it says in that verse, it says all about persevering, right? That's getting through hard times. So do you think that, you know, pastors faced with like a lot of hard situations when people come to them with their problems? Absolutely. So he is always the person who we come to. And so it is just, he is blessed because he has so much perseverance in such hard times, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the next one is about how Pastor and Mary both, he's our shepherd, right? So Pastor Beyer shepherds us in so many ways. He leads worship, he preps sermons, he preps Bible studies, and so does Mary, right? She does a Bible study with women, and she also does Sunday school for all the teachers. You guys have had Mary, right?
Yep.
Yeah, you guys have had Mary. So she has been, Mrs. Beyer, she has been your teacher before, and they are just so amazing. Also, Mrs. Beyer has taught VBS for a really long time, right? Is that a huge blessing to so many kids? It sure is. Boy, we're fitting a lot of blessings into this cup. Look at this. We're not even done yet. So it says in Hebrews 13:7, it says, remember your leaders, who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. So it says on there, it says, remember your leaders, right? So did Pastor Beyer go to school to become a pastor? Mm-hmm. He sure did, right? And so he remembered his leaders who spoke the word of God to him, right? And so then he brought the word of God to us, which is another blessing, right? So we're putting more blessings in there.
Even more.
It's amazing how many blessings we can fit in here, right?
We're halfway.
I know. It's amazing. So it says, consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. So Pastor Beyer and Mary Beyer are those kinds of people who we can imitate their faith, right? So we want to be more like them because they want to be like Jesus, right? Exactly. Okay. So let me ask you, do you guys remember seeing Pastor Beyer and Mary sing in the choir? Mm-hmm. They sure do. They love to sing. Is that a huge blessing to St. Mark? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Music is a huge blessing that they bring to St. Mark, right? So in Psalm 95:1, it says, "O come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation." So we could go on and on and on. There's so many things that Pastor does that we don't even know, right? Imagine all the things in the office that we don't even know goes on. How he helps all of the staff. I mean, we could go on and on forever, right? Mary Beyer has been such a blessing to so many of us too, especially kids and especially all of us families. So look at all those blessings that we fit in there. Can you imagine? That's a lot of blessings,
now
right?
Now water looks like milk.
I know. It's pretty amazing. So,
and boop.
So, well, oh, and Max has the next one. Hold on. One before we put that last one in, Max. So this last one is going to represent you guys, okay? So let me ask you, do you know ways how you can help be a blessing to St. Mark or a blessing to other people? What are some ideas that you have? What
like
do you think?
Like helping out?
Helping out, right? Like if we have an event or anything like that. Max, what are you? Can you think of an idea of how you can help the church or help other people?
Maybe like pray for the church?
You could pray for the church, exactly. So I want you to think of that. So in Matthew 20:28, it says, "Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many," right? So this last one right here is to remind us that we can be like Pastor Beyer and Mary Beyer and how we can come and serve instead of just being served, right? So we just want to say thank you. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Mary, for the amazing service you've done to St. Mark. Bye-bye, everybody. Put that.